Hello and welcome to another episode of Mashable Lab podcast. Today we are joined by Meher and Saad, authors. They both are journalists by profession, and they are authors of Pakistan: A Fashionable History. This is the first book in Pakistan of its kind, which basically documents and archives the fashion history of Pakistan. Hello and welcome, guys.
Hello.
Hello, Fatima. Thank you for having us on Mashable's podcast. Truly happy to be here.
It's a pleasure. So let's just dive right in. How did this happen? How did the idea of this book came about, and how did you guys ended up collaborating on it?
Thank you, Fatima. That's a great question to start off with. Everybody thinks that we were having dinner at Versace's mansion and they told us to, you know, write this book, and we were having we were funded by Karl Lagerfeld, you know, as it happens in the fashion world. But that's not true. It was a very ordinary, mundane morning when I was dropping my son off to school. It was one of those days when everything goes wrong. I'd had a baby and I was sitting wearing tracks and t-shirt covered with baby Cerelac and milk and breakfast, and the car in front of me had another mom dropping her child off, and she was dressed to the hilt. Yet she looked as miserable as I was feeling, and that triggered something inside of me, and I just thought, who is telling this woman to dress the way she is? And that's how Saad and I sort of embarked on this journey to look into the fashion industry, what it's about, who are the trendsetters, and how did they come about?
Saad, any you want to add on this?
Yeah, unlike Meher, I had a pretty good day. You know, I woke up late. And, you know, maybe I thank patriarchy for that, because, you know, I didn't have much to do. So I just woke up and it was like a normal day. Always big on collaboration. So I remember, you know, I messaged Meher saying that, you know, we should collaborate on something. I have known Meher for quite some time. Meher used to run this blog called Big Ben, right? Meher, that was the name?
Yeah.
Yeah. So I think that's when she was based in England. So I remember writing for it, but we had never collaborated on anything. And for someone like me, I write, I photograph, I'm also a musician. So I'm always big on collaborations. And, you know, I believe, you know, with collaborations, you can obviously do more. And so Meher pitched this idea. It's purely Meher's idea that we should do a book on the Pakistani fashion industry. And I agreed that, yes, you know, we should obviously work on this. So we decided to meet, and, you know, it was obviously decided that for something like this, it can't be, you know, contemporary fashion as in what it is right now, because we all know what it is right now, right? So I always wanted to know, you know, as we're both, you know, investigative journalists in a sense, so we both, you know, in a way wanted, I from a visual perspective and Meher through her text and profiles, we wanted to explore and discover, you know, and investigate basically how the fashion industry came into being. You know, it's one of our actual proper industries, unlike other industries which don't exist, like, you know, the music industry is non-existent. So I was obviously, it was a question I always had, you know, that how did this industry come into being? So we met, you know, and we had a rough structure in mind. It was initially more about designers, less about other people associated with the industry. And I, from the very, you know, initial stage, realized that I have to get a lot of archives. I would have to, you know, run around for a lot of these old photos and everything. Meher found someone in Islamabad who had really old vintage ads. So I cannot take credit for those, at least, because this gentleman has taken the task of actually archiving those vintage ads, you know, from the 50s and the 60s. But for more of the recent stuff, like a lot of the editorial shoots that were printed in the 80s and 90s, I had to go to Karachi, because that's where all of your, you know, print media essentially is based, and now obviously the broadcast side of it as well, because Dawn has always been based in, you know, in Karachi. The same goes for Newsline, which sadly has shut down now, in addition to Herald. So I think we were very lucky that right when these magazines were, you know, being shut down, I was able to get access to them. Their editors were kind enough to, you know, let me in their basements for like 5-6 hours, and, you know, just go through. And obviously living in Lahore was always a problem. So, but I always tell this that I mean, this is my first book. This is not Meher's first book, but at least in my case, I felt that this would be easy, you know, at least for my part. I would just, you know, ring up all these famous people and their assistants, you know, they would just email me and share their archives. But that was not the case. And, you know, there is no concept of actually archiving here. So it was quite a difficult process. But luckily, whatever we have in the book is very exclusive. And I think this will go a long way, you know, as archives, as text in the book.
Okay, so you guys, जैसे मेहर ने भी बता रही थी कि you know कैसे idea आया of you know the way she was dressed on that morning and the way she watched another mother. What is the definition of Pakistani fashion? Is there any a thing that can be मतलब is this something that can be defined specifically in this global culture and this global village that we live in? आप define कर सकते हैं कि जी this is what is the definition of Pakistani culture specifically. Given हमारी जो history है सारा and you know we were part of a continent पहले and वो सारा कुछ they all those sure. had. So what's yeah. your take on that?
I think first and foremost we all have to understand and acknowledge that Pakistani fashion is basically what we have at the grassroots level जो हमारा craft है जो हमारा local grassroots level पे indigenous craft है वो Pakistani fashion की जड़ है वो फाउंडेशन है वो प्लेटफॉर्म है इट्स ऑन द बेसिस ऑफ दैट दैट आवर डिजाइनर्स आर एबल टू हैव एन एस्थेटिक टू वर्क विद ओके सेकेंडली आई गो थ्रू ऑल द एलिमेंट्स दैट मेक अ पाकिस्तानी फैशन सेकेंडली आवर बेसिक सिलुएट व्हिच इज द शलवार कमीज नाउ वी आर आवर फैशन इज सब कॉन्टिनेंटल वी आर अ प्रोडक्ट वी आर एन ऑफशूट ऑफ व्हाट द सब कॉन्टिनेंट वाज व्हाट साउथ एशिया वाज So our dressing initially was always very subcontinental. There were gararas, there were saris, there were lehengas, cholis, jo abhi bhi hain hamare grassroots level pe. So the shalwar kameez came about as part of a Pakistani dress, which is fine. National identity hai hamari, the shalwar kameez, local craft. Thirdly, one of the things that makes Pakistani fashion different from, let's say, other South Asian fashion, particularly in India, or even Western fashion, is the fact how we have always merged our craft and our basic silhouette together to create a dress sense that falls within the Eastern and the Western realm. The original lot of designers, they did this perfectly. If you look at Seher Sehgal's work, if you look at Maheen Khan's work, if you look at Faiza Sami's work, if you look at रिजवान बेग का काम देखें रिजवान की सबसे मशहूर बात हुई थी जब उन्होंने प्रिंसेस डायना के लिए कपड़े बनाए थे उन्होंने कोई वेस्टर्न कट्स इस्तेमाल नहीं किए थे उन्होंने ईस्टर्न कट्स इस्तेमाल किए थे और उस पर सारा ईस्टर्न पाकिस्तानी काम ही हुआ हुआ था मोती सफ़ेद कढ़ाई सारा कुछ था सो आई थिंक जो हमारे ओरिजिनल डिज़ाइनर्स का अगर आप काम देखें दैट इज़ पाकिस्तानी फैशन What we have today in the form of bridals, in the form of high street, which is just what, kurti aur ek niche legging pehen li, This is not Pakistani fashion. This is some weird, this is not even style. This is just, you know, susti pana, frankly speaking. Bridals hain, bante hain, kyunki paise aate hain, aur high street pe koi investi karna chahta. If there's any one brand jo abhi high street pe sahi tarah se wo kaam kar rahe hain, it is probably generation. Otherwise, hamare haan hamesha culture raha hai khule kapde ka aur darzi culture. और वो अगर कपड़ा आप देखना चाहते हैं तो बारीज़े इस क्विंटेसेंशियली पाकिस्तानी सो आई थिंक द पाकिस्तानी फैशन लुक इट्स ऑलवेज बीन मॉडर्न इट्स ऑलवेज बीन वेरी फ्रेश एंड इट्स ऑलवेज बीन यूनिक बट इन ऑर्डर टू इनकैप्सुलेट इट टू डिफाइन इट वन हैज टू लुक एट द बेसिक सिलहुएट द शलवार कमीज़ एंड बेसिक लोकल क्राफ्ट
अच्छा सो टॉकिंग अबाउट आपने बताया कि यू नो इसका एक ऑब्वियसली फैशन इज नॉट समथिंग दैट इसकी वो एक अब हार्ड कोर साइंटिफिक डेफिनेशन कुछ क्रिएट कर सकें बट यू कैन यू नो जिस तरह मेहर ने डिस्क्राइब किया कि जी आप कट्स क्या होते हैं व्हाट आर आउटलाइंस आर टेकिंग ऑन दिस फैशन का रोल बिकॉज वी से फैशन यू नो इज अ फॉर्म ऑफ एक्सप्रेशन एंड इट्स एन इंटीग्रल पार्ट ऑफ द कल्चर So, iska socio-political landscape mein kya iski standing hai? Does it, you know, make a statement? Does it help? Does it not help? Can fashion be used to be, you know, be a be a form of, you know, maybe protest or resistance, uska koi aspect hai, aapko Pakistani fashion mein uske koi wo milte hain, traces milte hain, is tarah ki cheezon ke?
Bilkul ho sakta hai, fashion sirf ek 3-piece lawn ka joda nahi hai, fashion sirf ek shaadi ka joda bhi nahi hai. फैशन पाकिस्तान में अगर आप इसकी हिस्ट्री देखें, अक्सर लोग समझते हैं कि फैशन एक रिएक्शन था कि जो पाकिस्तान की तारीख में जो हालात हुए हैं, जो जंगें लड़ी गई हैं पाकिस्तान के अंदर भी, पाकिस्तान के इर्द गिर्द भी, रीजनली इंटरनेशनली, फैशन एक रिएक्शन आया था दिखाने के लिए कि जी पाकिस्तान इज अ मॉडर्न कंट्री. दैट इज़ नॉट ट्रू एट ऑल. फैशन इंडस्ट्री इज ऑलवेज रिटेन्ड इट्स इंडिपेंडेंस फ्रॉम पॉलिटिक्स. हाउएवर, फैशन इज a very strong social and cultural indication of Pakistan's own history. And unfortunately, is pe zyada research nahi hui hai, is pe zyada logon ne tawajjuh bhi nahi di hai. Halanki main samajhti hu, agar aap Pakistan ki tareekh ko samajhna chahte hain, Pakistan ki culture ko samajhna chahte hain, Pakistani ko samajhna chahte hain, aap uski fashion ko dekho. Aap dekho ki logon ke taiyar hone ke tareeke kaise badle gaye hain, logon ke libas kaise badle gaye hain. और फैशन एक लिबरेटिंग फोर्स भी रहा है. मसलन कि हमारी किताब में अगर आप देखेंगे, आप अतिया खान की कहानी पढ़ेंगे, अतिया खान पाकिस्तान की पहली सुपर मॉडल थी. नो वन हैज़ बीन एबल टू इमिलेट हर सक्सेस. अतिया खान के लिए मॉडलिंग जो था, उन्होंने ये कोई गंदा या कोई फहाश काम नहीं किया था. उन्होंने ये काम किया था दिखाने के लिए कि भाई एक औरत अपने जिस्म, अपने लिबास के बारे में खुद अपने डिसीजंस बना सकती हैं. और अगर आप देखिए इसे गौर तरीके से, तो जिस तरह एक ब्रांड था पाकिस्तान का सबसे मशहूर ब्रांड था टीजेस, तनवीर जमशेद साहब ने जो बनाया था, इट वाज़ द फर्स्ट पाकिस्तानी ब्रांड टू गो इंटरनेशनल. इनफैक्ट ये प्रेट लाइन वाज़ द फर्स्ट फॉर्म ऑफ पाकिस्तानी फैशन दैट केम अबाउट लॉन्ग बिफोर कुचोर, बिफोर द बंटो काजमीज एंड ऑल द अदर्स केम अबाउट, एंड द रिजवान बेग एंड उमर सईद एंड ऑल दे केम अबाउट. देयर वाज़ टीजेस. टीजेस ने क्या किया था? टीजेस ने कहा था कि ठीक है, मैं कपड़े बनाऊंगा पीटीवी के ड्रामो सीरियल के लिए. सबसे पहले उन्होंने किया था किरण कहानी के लिए. अच्छा जी, थ्रू दैट मीडियम हमारा सेलिब्रिटी कल्चर बना. जो हमारी औरतें थी, जो पहले अलकरम और गुल अहमद की एड देखती थी अखबारों में, जाते थे जंग में आ गया, स्टार में आ गया, वो देख के वो सिलवाती थी कपड़े. उनको आप देखना चाहती थी कि मरीना खान क्या पहनेगी इस ड्रामे में. उसका कट बड़ा अच्छा था, उसके पफ स्लीव बड़े अच्छे थे, उसके कफ्स बहुत अच्छे थे. तो वो एक एक्सप्रेशन बन गया था, एक कम्युनिकेशन टूल बन गया था कि हाउ टू लुक फैशनेबल, हाउ टू लुक स्टाइलिश. बट इट्स आल्सो स्ट्रॉन्गर देन दैट, देयर वाज आल्सो अ पॉलिटिकल मैसेज. जब ज़ियाउल हक का दौर आया था, तो टीजेस ने क्या कहा था, जब औरतों को कहा गया था कि सर पर दुपट्टे करो, चादरें पहनो, बुरके पहनो, आपने जिस्म नहीं दिखाना, आपने बाल नहीं दिखाने, आपने आंखें नहीं दिखानी, तो उन्होंने क्या किया था, उन्होंने कहा था कि ठीक है, अगर ऐसी बात है तो औरत के लिए उन्होंने ही इंट्रोड्यूस something known as androgynous fashion. Androgynous fashion क्या होता है? वो होता है जब एक औरत एक ऐसा लिबास पहनती है जो उसका डिजाइन औरत के लिए होता है, लेकिन उसका सिलुएट, उसकी कट औरत की शेप की नहीं होती है. So it was also a political statement being made that you can take away a woman's femininity, you can take away a woman's sexual power, but at the end of the day she's still a woman and she knows how to show it. And she will. So I see fashion as a huge force. Abhi recently, agar aap dekhen to Generation, jo hamara Lahore-based homegrown brand hai, Pret ka, unhone Shehzad Malik ke saath ek badi si collaboration ki thi, jahan pe unhone kameezein banayi thi aur unke upar khawateen ki shaklein print ki hui thi, sher o shayari thi, aur Shehzad ka artwork bhi tha. Wo bhi ek statement hi tha na, jo aajkal ke daur ki aurtein, bachiyan jo hain, wo kehna chahti hain. अगर आप जुबान काट लेंगे, आप काट लें, लेकिन आप फिर भी फैशन के तरीके से, आर्ट के तरीके से आप एक एक्सप्रेशन रोक नहीं सकते. तो मैं समझती हूँ कि फैशन एक बहुत पावरफुल टूल है. अभी तक हम लोगों ने इसको सही तरह से यूटिलाइज नहीं किया टू इट्स फुल पोटेंशियल, क्योंकि इसमें मर्द के लिए भी बहुत कुछ हो सकता है, बच्चों के लिए भी बहुत कुछ हो सकता है. आई सी अ लॉट ऑफ ब्रांड्स कमिंग अप, जहाँ पे अभी रिसेंटली इंस्टाग्राम पे किसी ने मुझे दिखाया था कि शॉले थी, उन शॉलों पे फैज़ की शेर व शायरी की प्रिंट हुए हुए थे. आई मीन व्हाट अ लवली थिंग, व्हाट अ लवली थिंग. बहुत कुछ है करने को.
सो मेहर, जिस तरह आप बता रहे थे, तो और कि यू नो यू सॉर्ट ऑफ helped see ke ji fashion ke jo hamare trends the how they have you know over the span of the our history us pe uska ek reflection hai. So that brings me to the point of archiving. Jaise Saad ne kaha ki archives nahi matlab itne readily available nahi hai Pakistan mein, archiving ka culture nahi hai. Fashion industry ki to ek baat hai, I believe ki kisi bhi aur field mein bhi aap jaye aap archives jo hain wo ek bahut problem hai hoti hai dhoondne ke liye. In other places there are libraries, there are sections dedicated for just archiving. So just talk about the importance of archiving, how your book you know sort of plays is going to play a role in it, and saath the treasures that you have collected sare to nahi aapne kitab mein share kiye honge na kuch jo nahi kiye unke bare mein bataye.
Yeah, so I feel ke you know here in Pakistan we have this thing called you know holding hai hamari yahan pe agar kisi ke paas hote bhi hain so people don't generally share. For example, when we came out with the book some of my friends they shared that you know aap hame batate yaar mere paas purane magazine pade hue the maine phenk diye you know. So people generally don't like to share. Also archiving ka as I mentioned earlier concept nahi hai. A lot of the designers jinse hamari baat hui jis tarah I told you ki I assumed it was wrong of me to assume but I assumed ki inke paas apna kaam to hoga. Photographers luckily jis tarah Tapu Jhaveri is featured in our book unki apni kitabe do aa chuki hain. So उन्होंने अपने ही पब्लिशर से कहा कि जी मेरे आर्काइव्स जो हैं वो आप मुझे दे दें, इनको चाहिए कुछ. तो थोड़े बहुत उन्होंने शुक्र हमें दे दिए अपने. बट देयर इज अनदर फोटोग्राफर इन द बुक, आसिफ रजा साहब, जो आई वुड से ही इज द फादर ऑफ कमर्शियल फोटोग्राफी इन पाकिस्तान. ही डिड नॉट हैव एनी ऑफ हिज ओन आर्काइव्स. इनफैक्ट उन्होंने हमें रिक्वेस्ट की कि जी अगर आपको कुछ मिलता है तो प्लीज मेरे साथ शेयर कीजिएगा. सो यहाँ पे वो कॉन्सेप्ट नहीं है, यहाँ पे वो पब्लिकली एक्सेसिबल लाइब्रेरीज नहीं है आपकी. मे बी इंस्टीट्यूट्स में होती होंगी बट जनरली इफ एनी वन इज डूइंग अ बुक फॉर एग्जाम्पल किसी भी चीज पे, नॉट जस्ट फैशन, आई एम श्योर अगर कोई म्यूजिक पे करना चाहे किसी और चीजों पे आपको शायद वो कुछ लोगों की पर्सनल लाइब्रेरीज में ऐसी चीजें होंगी वो भी आपके ताल्लुकात उनसे जैसे हैं उस पर डिपेंड करता है. सो नॉट एवरी वन इज गोइंग टू अलाउ यू एक्सेस टू दैट. सो दैट इज देयर इज नो कॉन्सेप्ट. आई मेंशन्ड कि किस तरह मैं न्यूजीलैंड की बेसमेंट में आई वॉज देयर फॉर 6-7 आवर्स. तो आई ऑल्सो रियलाइज उसी वक्त कि यहाँ पे और बड़ा कुछ है. There were a lot of other things, you know, about what ye jis tarah you know we always Meher mentioned this in a previous interview as well that a lot of the kids who picked up our books, for example, ye aapne dekha hoga ki Instagram pe kabhi kabhar aap purane archives dekhte hain Pakistan ke aur aap sochte hain yaar ye 70s 80s 90s mein Pakistan seemed to be a very interesting place to live, what happened, where did we go wrong, you know. Chalo 90s ko ab rehne de, at least 70s 80s there used to be this amazing magazine. You were not in Pakistan, maybe in the 90s, I guess. So
I was.
Okay. So there used to be a magazine called Dinak, for example, back in the I think 70s, 80s, and my father used to tell me about those magazines. The kind of covers it had, you can't have those covers in 2020 for any magazine in Pakistan. It can be an online edition only. बट उस तरह के नहीं हो सकते. दे वर वेरी बोल्ड मैगजीन, बड़ा कुछ हो रहा था एंड इट वॉज इन उर्दू. मतलब अलॉट ऑफ दीज पब्लिकेशन, ऐसा नहीं है कि जी वो अंग्रेजी में थे तो वो अंग्रेज पढ़ने वाले ही उसको करते थे. तो वो आर्काइव्स का कॉन्सेप्ट है ही नहीं यहाँ पे. मुझे आई हैड टू गो टू ओल्ड बुक स्टोर्स स्पेशली इन कराची, बिकॉज कराची में ये इस बात पर मुझे थोड़ा सा लोगों का गुस्सा आ सकता है, लेकिन कुछ थोड़ा एस्थेटिक्स उस शहर के बेहतर हैं, थोड़ा टेस्ट वहाँ पे, थोड़ा लोगों के थोड़ा कॉन्सेप्ट बेहतर है और वहाँ पे कुछ इंस्टीट्यूशंस कुछ पुराने हैं. सो वहाँ पे स्पेशली अराउंड सदर देयर वर अ फ्यू बुक स्टोर्स. जब मैं गया अवल तो देवर वेरी सरप्राइज कि जी आपको ये क्यों चाहिए, ये तो रद्दी है, यू नो, ये तो जो स्ट्रीट हॉकर्स हैं बेचारे, दे यूज दिस पेपर यू नो टू सेल देयर स्टफ बिकॉज दिस इज यू नो हेयर वी डोंट रिसाइकल पेपर, वी जस्ट यू नो ओल्ड यूज ओल्ड न्यूज पेपर फॉर एग्जाम्पल. तो वो चीज़ बड़ी जरूरी थी. तो मैं जब न्यूजीलैंड की बेसमेंट में था, आई started taking photos, you know, of anything I felt would be of relevance in the future, you know, like it could be music, anything, art. So usme I found a lot of, I felt the editorials were also very bold. For example, agar aap editorials padhte, Razia Bhatti, unki amazing editor hoti thi way back in the 90s and late 80s. She died very early, bichari, but unke editorials maine padhe ki is tarah ki cheeze aap 2020 mein nahi likh sakte Pakistan mein. So I think journalistically, musically, culturally, in terms of fashion style, usme bada kuch mila. And this is just one publication. To wo concept bilkul nahi tha. I met also a lot of other people who I felt kar sakte the. उन्होंने कहा जी हम अपनी किताब पे काम कर रहे हैं इसलिए हम आपको कुछ नहीं दे सकते. और मैंने उनको कहा कि जी ठीक है अच्छी बात है इफ यू आर वर्किंग ऑन समथिंग बिकॉज इट्स वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट कि लोग ये चीजें निकालें. सो वो ही बात है कि यू नो लोगों के पास बड़ा कुछ होता है पीपल डोंट शेयर दैट थिंग हियर. सो आर्काइविंग इज वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट. आई थिंक लास्ट मंथ आई टुक अ कपल ऑफ स्टूडेंट्स टू यू नो सम ऑफ दीज ओल्ड प्लेसेस इन लाहौर फॉर एग्जांपल. तो मैंने उनको बताया कि जी जो आप फ्रेस्कोस देख रहे हैं दीज आर इंडेंजर्ड राइट बिकॉज यू कैन नॉट रिक्रिएट देम. फ्रेस्कोस इज द आर्ट ऑफ वेजिटेबल एंड फ्रूट डाई. उससे आप जो एक आर्ट वर्क क्रिएट करते हैं वो 16th सेंचुरी में अंडर शाहजहां अ लॉट ऑफ दीज स्ट्रक्चर्स वर बिल्ट इन द सबकॉन्टिनेंट. सो उसमें यू कैन आइडेंटिफाई स्पेसिफिक फॉर एग्जाम्पल वजीर खान मौसी सारी की उस टाइम में ये बनी हुई है. अब वो वाइट वॉशिंग हिस्ट्री की हो रही है तो वैसे ही आर्काइव्स और प्रेशियस हो जाते हैं आपके. सो ऑल दीज ओल्ड बिल्डिंग्स दे आर जस्ट बीइंग वाइट वॉश्ड लिटरली. इसी तरह आपकी हिस्ट्री में इतनी डिस्टॉर्शन है एंड द ओनली वे यू कैन प्रिजर्व दैट हिस्ट्री इज थ्रू आर्काइव्स. यू नो व्हेन आई हैव ओल्ड क्लिपिंग्स फ्रॉम द 90s 50s और 60s आई कैन एक्सप्लेन कि दिस इज हाउ थिंग्स वर कंपेयर्ड टू समवन हु इज एक्चुअली डिस्टॉर्टिंग हिस्ट्री. तो वो तो हमें नहीं पता ना. और इतना हमारा डिस्कनेक्शन है अपनी हिस्ट्री से which leads to a lot of problems like identity crisis and what not. तो आपकी जो youth है वो you know जब उनको हम ये किताब दिखाते हैं तो वो मानते नहीं है. and you know they finally have something to be proud of, you know, the way things, maybe not the way things evolved but what it was back in the days. so I always stress on this thing कि जी archiving is very important. and I also mentioned this कि सिर्फ पुरानी तस्वीरें archives नहीं होती. you know sounds, people like there are, as a musician I would say there were certain musicians जो वो खुद बेचारे नहीं रहे उनकी इंस्ट्रूमेंट्स नहीं रहे. देयर वर लॉट ऑफ दीज एंडेंजर्ड इंस्ट्रूमेंट्स दैट वी हैड उनके बनाने वाले नहीं रहे. सो आर्काइविंग इज नॉट जस्ट इमेजेस इट्स साउंड इट कुड बी अ फैब्रिक फॉर एग्जांपल यू नो जो अब नहीं बनता. मुल्तानी आर्ट में फॉर एग्जांपल वो मुल्तानी मट्टी जो ग्लेज्ड एक पॉटरी थी वो अब नहीं बनती. उसका चाइना क्ले का एक न्यूअर फॉर्म बनता है. सो सम अ लॉट ऑफ पीपल हैव दोज पुरानी अपने घर में चीजें बट नया वो नहीं बनता. सो वो एक ग्लेज्ड पॉटरी वो भी एक एंशियंट चीज होगी है एंड इट्स वेरी प्रेशियस अगर उसके बनाने वाले नहीं रहे. वो चीजें बड़ी जरूरी है एंड इट्स ऑल पार्ट ऑफ आर्काइविंग.
ट्रू. अच्छा एज यू सेड कि यू नो आर्काइविंग तो एक प्रॉब्लम है ही है. लेट्स टॉक अबाउट पब्लिशिंग बिकॉज़ एज यू सेड कि यू नो वो पुरानी अगर मैगजीन्स और वो रदी के लिए कंसिडर हो रहे हैं तो खैर वो तो एक सेपरेट आई थिंक उस पर हम पॉडकास्ट कर सकते हैं ऑफ व्हाट दैट्स गोना रिजल्ट. बट टॉकिंग अबाउट पब्लिकेशन यू नो बिकॉज वो आपका एक्सपीरियंस आई थिंक एज यू सेड कि मेहर की तो ये फर्स्ट बुक नहीं है बट व्हाट्स द पब्लिकेशन कल्चर यहाँ पे पीपल हु आर इन द इंडस्ट्री एंड यू नो मे बी नो पीपल या नो द प्रोसीजर फॉर समवन जो हमारे यंग बच्चे हैं बिकॉज through our work I got to know about a few people who unhone bahut like 17 18 years old ke who are interested in writing wanted to publish something but never got the support so wo end pe aake they ended up getting self published but uske liye bhi obviously they went through a lot so aap log batao aap logo ka experience kaisa tha and kya hamare you know weak points hain loopholes hain in our local publishing industry.
I think initially when obviously I would like Meher to add on to this but main just ek chota sa intro to what I feel you know is happening in industry. Way back in, you know in 2017 when we started this book we reached out to a couple of people in you know the Indian publishing industry because hame ye realization thi ki something like this it would be handled properly more professionally jisme hamara bhi khayal rakha jayega you know when it comes to royalties that an author deserves theek hai sari cheeze and you know hamara koi lena dena nahi hoga with the design the layout the editing so Meher would just be writing the book you know and zahira ek rough edit draft she would have submitted I would be you know collecting all the imagery the visuals you know the archives and you know we would be going you know over with them you know matlab unke sath ke ji ye dalna chahiye this is what we think would look good on the covers. उसमें फिर ये हुआ कि वी स्टार्टेड द बुक एंड वी हैड अ डील विद एन इंडियन पब्लिशिंग हाउस फॉर एग्जांपल. तो एवरीथिंग वाज गोइंग ओके. फिर लास्ट ईयर पॉलिटिकली हमारी इंडिया के साथ नेचुरली थिंग्स लाइक वेंट इन अ कंप्लीटली डिफरेंट डायरेक्शन. वी वर ऑन द ब्रिंक ऑफ वॉर एंड व्हाट नॉट. उसमें एंड आई वुड लाइक टू ऐड दिस के बिफोर यू नो साइनिंग अप विद दीस गाइस आई वाज अ बिट आप कह लें अंडर एस्टिमेटिंग द फैशन इंडस्ट्री इन द सेंस मुझे था कि विद इन पाकिस्तान दे वुड बी इंटरेस्टेड But I did not realize that even across the border and internationally, Pakistani fashion industry ka kafi scene hai. You know, it's like quite a big thing. So they kept insisting that nahi, nahi, hang on, things will improve. But we are journalists, so we realized that things are only going to worsen. And this book is something we have worked really hard, you know, on. So, to hume tha ke, let's give them some time. But ultimately, it was decided that we'll do this locally. So usme ye hai ke Meher reached out to a lot of local publishers, for example, but hame usme realize hua ki the amount of hard work that we've put in, you know, the interviews, the countless interviews that Meher had done, you know, over the telephone, pata nahi kitne ka telephone bill bana, theek hai, kya nahi hua, my trips to Karachi, which I would be thankful to my band, agar mujhe khud shayad fund karne padte, so I would have never been able to do that, you know, going to Karachi, staying over, you know, for a few days and, you know, trying to get hold of people. Because let's be honest, jo kitab mein hamare log featured hain, they're not someone jo aap jaake bas milne unko, you know. They're busy people, they're famous people. So, wo phir zahir hai, we realized ki sari cheeze hame khud karni padengi. So much so ke hame tha ki chalein publish ho bhi jati hai. To the bookstores over here, they do not, you know, really offer us tarah ka incentive aap keh lein. So Meher took this task. Initially, Meher tried really hard, you know, trying to convince the government, for example. She went up to the commerce ministries and all these relevant ministries ki ji aap kitab kaise ban kar sakte hain. To hame bada kaha gaya ki ji aap India se kyun chhapwa rahe hain. To humne unko samjhaya ki ji because local publishing industry is tarah ki cheez mein nahi interested and wo Indian publishing industry is interested in this thing and ye puri kitab puri duniya mein jayegi, theek hai. To isme Pakistan ka fayda ya nuksan to hame nahi samajh aati kya hai, theek hai. So Meher ne bahut koshish ki lekin jab hame samajh aa gayi ki ye कहीं बाहर से स्पेशली इंडिया से किताब नहीं आ सकती टू बी डिस्ट्रीब्यूटेड. सो Meher बिल्ट हर ओन थिंग कॉल्ड ज़ुका बुक्स जिसमें वी रियलाइज्ड कि दिस इज अ गुड स्टार्ट ऑफ एंड वी रियलाइज्ड कि इंस्टेड हम ये खुद छाप के गायब हो जाएंगे बस ठीक है हमारी किताब तो निकल गई. सो उसमें Meher डिसाइडेड कि यार शी इज नॉट गोइंग टू लेट अदर पीपल गो थ्रू व्हाट वी वेंट एंड यू नो शी विल टेल यू व्हाई शी सेट अप ज़ुका बुक्स. थैंक यू Meher.
थैंक यू सर, वेरी काइंड ऑफ यू. देखिए फातिमा, आई ऑफ्टन फील के पाकिस्तानीज में लिखने का बहुत पोटेंशियल है बिकॉज ऑफ नॉट जस्ट आवर सोशियो इकोनॉमिक मेकअप बट बिकॉज ऑफ व्हाट द कंट्री गोज थ्रू एंड हाउ वी हैड टू यू नो वी ऑल हैड टू ग्रो अप वेरी वेरी क्विकली बिकॉज ऑफ इवेंट्स एंड आई थिंक वी फील देम अ लॉट मोर. करंट पब्लिशिंग सीन जो है मुझे दुख होता है कहने का कि इट्स नॉट वेरी कंड्यूसिव for new writers at the moment. Hamari jo publishing industry hai usme masle masail bahut hain, piracy ke, copyright ke, royalties ke, contracts ke, bahut masle hain. Lekin main dekhti hu ke kai aise log, kai chand log hain jo kaam kar rahe hain is industry ko theek karne ke liye. Maslan ke तैयबा अब्बास साहिबा हैं जिन्होंने अपना शुरू किया है पब्लिशिंग हाउस कॉल्ड अला पब्लिशिंग. मेरा जो है इट्स मोर ऑफ अ पब्लिशिंग प्लेटफॉर्म वेयर आई होप टू बी एबल टू गिव न्यू राइटर्स अ चांस ऑफ एटलीस्ट गेटिंग देयर फुट थ्रू द डोर एंड देन आगे फिर उनकी अल्लाह किस्मत बेहतर करे. यू नो द आइडिया इज के ऑफ्टन पीपल डोंट गेट अ चांस एट ऑल एंड आई फेल टू अंडरस्टैंड व्हाई नॉट. I mean, one of the things that struck me was that wherever I went, whether it was abroad, whether it was in India, whether it was within Pakistan, nobody had a problem with the work itself. You know, ek hota na ki banda kehta hai ki ji aapka kaam sahi nahi hai. That's fine. That's justified. That's legitimate. Nobody had a problem with the content, but they all had problems with, I think, maybe with me as a female. I don't know. Or maybe they felt that they wanted ownership of this work. They didn't want Saad and my name on it. Or maybe they just, there was a lot of envy. इन्होंने कर लिया है, हम नहीं कर पाए. हालांकि ऐसी कोई बात नहीं है. I've always said that this book is just the first step. This is not exhaustive. This is not definitive. There's plenty of room for more. लेकिन to be denied a publishing opportunity internationally and regionally on the basis of being Pakistani, it does not make sense to me. To be denied getting published internally because it doesn't fit the publisher's plan, whatever plan there is, because there is no plan. You know, it's just aukhapan dikhana. Aapne aukha ho na to theek hai, aap aukhe ho. Hum apna kaam karenge aur karte rahenge. So there are opportunities. 17, 18 year olds.
Sorry, madam. I just want to add that initially, जब हमें समझ आई कि ये किताब हमें international उस तरह हम नहीं जा सकेंगे और सारा कुछ खुद करना पड़ेगा, an Indian friend out of all the people, an Indian friend remarked कि साद, I think this is the best time for the Pakistani publishing industry to shine. You know, this is the best time कि this ban could actually be beneficial to you guys. And I was like, yes. So when Meher came up with Zuka Books, तो मैंने कहा यार yes, this is, you know, this is the best time. You know, कि हम खुद इसको, you know, industry को ठीक है, exploitation है. हम, you know, there are many ways to bypass that. For example, initially when we started thought of distributing, marketing the book, तो हमने bookstores से कुछ से बात की. A lot of these huge bookstores in Pakistan, and we realized कि हमें अगर 5% मिलेगा, मतलब it's as simple as कि अगर आप 100 रुपए की वो किताब बेच रहे हैं, तो हमें वो 7 रुपए देंगे. ऐसे ही है ना, 5-7% सीधी सी बात है, ये बनता है. सो हमें समझ आ गई कि जी इस तरह तो नहीं हो सकता, और हमें किताब बहुत महंगी करनी पड़ेगी. मतलब आई विल बी वेरी ऑनेस्ट कि अगर हम आपको अपनी प्रोडक्शन कॉस्ट बताएं एंड फॉर व्हाटएवर प्राइस वी आर सेलिंग,
आई डोंट थिंक द बुक इज दैट एक्सपेंसिव. एग्जैक्टली. आई लुक एट अदर बुक्स. आई मीन एक किताब जो है छोटी सी हमारी किताब है, वो वेरी मिनिमल रिसर्च, वो 10,000 की जा रही है. सो आई रियली गेट नो व्हेन पीपल लाइक ओह इतनी महंगी किताब है, आई एम लाइक जी लॉन का जोड़ा ज्यादा महंगा है.
It's a coffee table book, ठीक है? It's not a paperback novel, ठीक है? जो and मतलब I'll tell you कि even इस सारी चीज का फायदा ही हुआ कि ठीक है, we were putting in our time and money, you know, we've pulled in for this book, ठीक है? As a project, as a product, जो भी. But मुझे इसमें ये satisfaction थी कि एक तो I'll be honest, it's a fashion thing, ठीक है? There were हमने ऐसी कोई फहाश, you know, images नहीं इसमें लगाई. But there were a few images which I felt for the 80s and 90s were very bold. So हमने जब किताब कुछ लोगों को दिखाई, कुछ bookstores को, कुछ publishers को, उन्होंने जाहिर सोचा कि जी हमारा नाम इसके साथ जाएगा, तो ये देख लीजिए, ये अगर हटा के कोई और लगा दें, तो for me that was a red flag, and I told Meher instantly कि यार ये काम ठीक नहीं है. So जब हमें समझ आ गई कि self publish हम कर रहे हैं, सारा कुछ अपनी resources खुद लगा रहे हैं, मुझे इस चीज की बड़ी खुशी थी कि we have creative control over the book, right? And at the same time, we're also 100% responsible for anything that goes wrong, right? I mean, Meher can't say ki ji ye to Zuka Books ki fault hai, because Meher is Zuka Books, right? So usme ye cheez, I think, so we had
so mujhe ye cheez the nail on the head with creative control.
Yeah, exactly.
Okay, so we could just move on towards some of the questions that have come from social media. And one of the questions is basically connected to what you guys were talking about. It's the first, this book is not the ultimate thing, but it is one sort of the first step in this direction. So somebody asked us on social media that, you know, what was your selection criteria? Who is going to make it and who is not? And also, are all the key people covered?
Yeah. So selection process was, once Saad and I decided to do this book, we started doing a lot of research. And I would tell any young author out there who wants to write a book, whether it's fiction, whether it's nonfiction, please, please, please do your research. Without your research, you cannot have a substantial book. You cannot have a plot line. You cannot have characters. You cannot have anything. आप अपनी रिसर्च करें, जितनी रिसर्च आप करेंगे वो कम है. एंड आई थिंक साद एंड आई फाउंड दैट बिकॉज यू नो व्हेन इट केम डाउन टू पुटिंग द डिजाइनर्स टुगेदर कि किस किस को डालना है, वी रियलाइज वी हैड टू डू इट क्रोनोलॉजिकली. अच्छा, क्रोनोलॉजिकली करना है तो रिप्रेजेंटेशन इशू आ जाता है. रिप्रेजेंटेशन की बात आ जाती है तो क्राफ्ट को भी कवर करना था. सो देयर वर अ लॉट ऑफ फैक्टर्स दैट केम इनटू बीइंग एंड अल्टीमेटली वी डिसाइडेड दैट वी हैड टू लुक एट पीपल हु वर the originals, the people who started the industry altogether. Jahan tak baat aa jati hai saaron ka, everybody who was in the book is part of the original lot of the fashion industry. There are about, I think, two people who are not in it because they were asked to be part of it, they refused. That is their loss. That's nothing to do with us. Unhone apni marzi ki. But other than that, everyone else in it is definitely part of the foundation, part of the group who created the foundation of the industry.
Yeah, and also I would like to add that Meher, you know, has been very transparent in this process, especially when it came to profiling people, you know, writing about them. So much so that I did not agree with some of Meher's approaches in terms of she let people read what she was writing about them. So I understand if a book is featuring me, I would like to know ki ji mere bare mein kya likha ja raha hai. But she would actually, you know, share everything with these people. So meri nazar mein ye tha ki this would really delay the process, because naturally if you are a celebrity, you know, so you would want ki nahi yaar ye nikal de, you know, is tarah. But at the same time, I'm glad that, you know, aisa kuch humne nahi filter kiya. Theek hai, Meher shared it with them and said ki ji this is how it's going to be like. So wo transparency inke saath sab rakhi, because we also realized ki backlash bahut major ho sakta hai. This is not a biography of one fashion designer. This is not a biography of a makeup artist or whatever. This has a lot of important people, you know, a lot of influential people in this book. So mujhe hamesha se ye tha ki yaar koi backlash ho sakta hai, kuch tarah ki cheez ho sakti hai. Lekin Allah ka shukr hai ki abhi tak aisa kuch nahi hua. And as far as I would say ki the way people responded to this book, you know, when we approached them, has also shaped the way the book is in a way. There were a lot of people jo hamare saath, they were being very difficult with us, and we gave them an equal opportunity to be featured, but they wanted certain people to be removed from the book. So we realized ki yaar ye to nahi ho sakta. You know, it's like, I mean, imagine ki you are doing a book on the politicians of Pakistan, and a certain party member says ki ji aap dusri party, rival party ke bande ko nikal dein, whereas they all form a part of the history. So we did mention these people. We may not have written more about them, us tarah they are mentioned, kuch logon ka kaam bhi hai us tarah, because we felt ke yaar theek hai, matlab agar is photographer ne hamare sath nahi for example cooperate kiya, but usne kisi us makeup artist ko shoot kiya hua, to humne usko credit de ke sari cheeze karke, we have done it very responsibly because we are journalists, and factually cheeze we had to make sure as well. So this is a very journalistic take on the fashion industry. I've always made it very clear, I'm not an expert on fashion. I'm not even a fashion photographer for that matter. So isliye to, you know, a lot of people have asked me, you know, like, are you a fashionable person, ya aapka fashion ke bare mein kya khayal hai. So I've made it very clear ki I'm more of an observer, and my role has been archiving obviously, or maybe, you know, helping Meher, you know, just connect with other people, or just, you know, recording on Meher's behalf, you know, certain interviews maybe. Isse zyada us tarah ka, I'm not an expert on fashion. So is tarah hai sara scene. So ye hai, but I think it's amazing how the initial idea was ki sirf designer honge, but humne socha ki nahi, isme publishers hain, isme makeup artists hain, isme photographers hain. There's so many people jo agar ye, who would have not collaborated, who would have not cooperated with these designers in the first place, to industry na hoti. Or it would have been a very smaller thing. It would not have been an industry in the first place. So yeah, and obviously hamari initial effort was never to be selective. Someone pointed this thing out ki you guys are lucky because you do not belong to a certain camp. We are also, I think, one of the biggest successes for people who know the fashion industry, jitna mujhe pata hai. It's a big achievement to bring both Lahore and Karachi under one book, trust me. I could not achieve one thing as a photographer for the book. That was having everyone in one single photograph on the cover. So wo phir jab hum, we got to know these people, we realized ke that's a very difficult thing to do.
Ye Pakistan mein ye zara mushkil ho jata kaam. Anyways, last question, what is, aap logon ne overall cover kiya ki, you know, how sara procedure kya tha, if you have to like sum it up in one line each of you, ke what do you hope that, you know, the readers take away from this book, whoever gets it, what's the one takeaway that you hope them to take from this book?
I would like to say that I would want readers to, you know, like jis tarah Meher mentioned, you know, that we have our own identity, you know, hamara ek apna hai sara. I would like them to have some sort of an ownership to the culture, you know, and also a realization of all the livelihoods that, for example, are associated with this industry. Meri nazar mein fashion shuru mein before, matlab, you know, even for me as a co-author, as a collaborator with Meher on this book for me has been very eye-opening in a way that I got to know so many things, you know, hamara local craft ka mujhe pata chala, theek hai, which Meher has very in detail mentioned in the book. I got to know about so many things, you know, while I was helping Meher with the research, or while I was just going through the archives, for example. I always used to think कि ये बड़ी एलीट चीज और मेरा इससे कोई लेना देना नहीं है, बट ट्रस्ट मी द वे वी ड्रेस अप इन व्हाटएवर वे इज इट इफ क्या हम फॉलो कर रहे हैं या हम उसके अगेंस्ट जा रहे हैं, इट ऑल इज इन्फ्लुएंस्ड बाय दैट एंड इट्स वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट. मतलब जो आपका लिबास है, जो आपकी जो भी चीजें हैं, एंड आई लाइक द फैक्ट दैट द बुक इज नॉट जस्ट अ फैशन, यू नो आप कह लो इट्स नॉट अ बुक ऑन फैशन, गिरी फैशन क्या है, देयर इज अ लॉट अबाउट हाउ थिंग्स हैव इन्फ्लुएंस्ड, यू नो सोशियो पॉलिटिकल, वो सारी चीजें बड़ी डिटेल में है, एंड व्हिच इज व्हाई द बुक इज आल्सो इन अ क्रोनोलॉजिकल ऑर्डर बिकॉज इट्स वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट टू सी हाउ दीस थिंग्स हैव शेप्ड अस. So yeah, so that's what I would say. I would want especially the youth to take an ownership, you know, of what we are and, you know, kis tarah hum yahan tak pahunche in short.
I think anyone who picks up the book, I would want them to think about ki kya se kya ho gaya, hum kya the aur aaj hum kya hain.
That's I think sums it up pretty well. Thank you guys for joining us, and hopefully we have you again, maybe you discuss in more in-depth detail on any one aspect of fashion here when you guys decide to do a part two of this book.
Oh,
thank you.
Not happening.